He's been to hell and back, and up and down, and is now, at age 33, living quietly in Tennessee, working on his autobiography, looking for a publisher, and attending acting school. Raised in a boxing family, Tommy Morrison first put on the gloves when he was only 7 years of age. Morrison fought 242 amateur bouts, mostly by the time he was 13 years of age. He began entering tough man contest at age 13 to put food on the table. In 1988, Tommy Morrison won the Kansas City Golden Gloves. In the Olympic trials, he advanced to the finals and lost to Army Sergeant Ray Mercer, 8 years his senior. From his debut in 1988 to his first title match in 1991, the Duke would hand out losses to 28 fighters, putting to sleep 24 and stopping 15 in the opening round, including big wins over James Tillis and Pinklin Thomas. He would also star beside actor Sylvester Stallone in Rocky V, which made the small town boy a household name as Tommy Gunn. In fact, I received phone calls all week, will Tommy Gunn be in Rochester for sure? Yes, he would. The stage was set for the undefeated rising star heavyweight to earn a belt when he challenged WBO heavyweight champ Ray Mercer for the title in 1991. Morrison was involved in one of the most horrifying knockouts in history, but this time Tommy was on the receiving side. The Duke led on the scorecards until the fifth, when Mercer landed the fateful punch that turned the lights out on Morrison's night. Tommy took the loss in stride and refused to give up. 8 wins later, all by way of knockout, Morrison again proved his toughness by battling it out with 2 broken hands. A broken jaw and a massive cut over his eye to stop Tough Joe Hip in the 9th round, setting up a title shot at the title he was once denied. This time he faced living legend Big George Foreman, who outboxed for 12 rounds to finally strap on his first hard-earned belt. Tommy would successfully defend his title, and in the second defense, he would face Michael the Fluke Benton. Benton floored Morrison 3 times in one of the most upsetting and abnormal losses of his career. After 2 years, 8 fights, and a hell of a win over Razor Ruddock, Morrison would step in the ring with 6'5", boxing great Lennox Lewis to be stopped in the 6th round. But Tommy's toughest test was yet to come. Tommy's world took a turn for the worse when the boxer would test positive as an HIV carrier. This would prove to be the toughest bout of the champ's life. Tommy would go on to fight one more time and would end his career as he began it 8 years earlier, with a first-round KO over Marcus Rose. Tommy announced his retirement from the sport of boxing at the age of 26. In his prime, Tommy Morrison proved that he was a born fighter. He owned one of the most dangerous left hooks in boxing and would brawl it out to win or loss at the sound of the bell without making any excuses. His final record was 46-3-1, and because of his great courage in and out of the ring, it is a pleasure to present Tommy Morrison, WBO heavyweight champion of the world, with the 205 Rochester Boxing Hall of Fame Jerry Flynn Courage Award.
I dig that.
You know, I'd like to
Talk into the mic so we can hear you.
You know, if you were so little, I'd kick your ass. I'm not familiar, this is the first time I've ever been to Rochester. I've been to Kansas a few times.
You don't know what you're missing.
I'm starting to find that out. You know, I've had a very enjoyable time since I've been here. Every time you get around one of these events, you know, a lot of the old flat crowd coming around, you get the opportunity to see a lot of people you haven't seen in a long time. And you can get caught up in what's going on in their life. You know, my career ended prematurely. You know, I don't know why things like that happen, but they do.
I get it.
And you know, what are you going to do? You're going to whine about it, or you're going to get on with it. I've always been that type of individual. And what I understand, I didn't know Jerry Swain. I never even heard of him. As a matter of fact, I got a scouting report about him on the way over here. I agreed to be a little dedication to the program. He's got a lot of the same qualities that I believe that I have. You know, no matter what, he always did whatever it took to get the job done. You know, and you got to have a natural born toughness about you to be a fighter. To excel in the sport, you've got to be mean, you know, in the ring. If you're outside the ring, I was a lot of things. Now, I never thought, you know, a million years that I'd ever be getting a courage award, maybe a wild child award, going down the line. But it's an honor, and it's good to see a lot of people I haven't seen in a while. And I want everybody to know that this time next year I'll be free. I'm going to give away another award. I want to wish Joe Mason luck. And Tom's a commission. I think that they blackballed me too. You know, there's a lot of things, that medications and things like that I was taking at the time that would cause a false positive. I really don't believe that it's there. They say it's undetectable. I'm not sure what that means. You know, so cut your brother in jail wrong, that means it's not there. But you know, it's still. But there's a reason for that. There's a reason for everything. You know, a person's got to step back and learn to be patient and look at every situation from every perspective, and not get in a hurry. You know, being patient, the Lord rewards you in a big way somewhere down the line. And you know, I believe there's a lot of things that I can do. I can act. I can commentate. Being American Gigolo. Wait a minute, I was already that one. And look where it got me. Cost me $38 million. Anyway, it's good to be here, and I just really dig you know, New York people. And you guys got all, you all have a certain glow about you, and you love life. And I love being around people that inspire me, and New York seems to always do that. So I appreciate it. You guys have a good evening. Thank you.
Tommy Orton.
I've never been here before. How you doing?
Hey, nice to meet you.